In this video, we will talk about the basis states for the position and momentum basis, which are often used in the Bra-Ket formalism of quantum mechanics. According to the postulates of quantum mechanics, a physical state is represented by a state vector, which is an element of some Hilbert space. And we denote this state vector with a so-called ket. Since this ket is an abstract thing, we usually want to find a representation of this state vector in the shape of a wave function, either in real space or momentum space. To do so, we can use certain basis vectors of the Hilbert space. For the position basis, we usually denote it with x or r, which is a placeholder for x, y, and z. And for the momentum basis, we have two options. We can either use the wave vectors k or the momenta p. Usually, momentum and wave vector are related via Planck's constant. But for the basis kets, this equation holds. It's not at all obvious why this should be the case, and we will explain this later in the video. The idea of these basis states is that we want to project the state vector psi onto them, which yields the wave functions in position space and momentum space. Let's now discuss some properties of these basis vectors. First of all, they are defined as the eigenvectors of the position and momentum operators. Which letter we write inside the ket does not matter too much. It simply helps us distinguish two different basis vectors and only affects the eigenvalues. These basis vectors are part of an orthogonal basis, which can be written by using the Dirac delta function. Note that this is actually an abbreviation for three separate delta functions. But these basis sets are not only orthogonal, they are also a complete basis, which means that we can expand any vector in this Hilbert space by using these basis states. The expansion coefficients can be obtained by projecting another basis to the left of this equation. Now, since we can write this expansion also like this, all of these terms together must be the identity operator, since then we have the ket A on the left and on the right-hand side of the equation. And this not only works for the position basis, but also for the momentum basis as well. Here you can see the connection between the momentum basis sets that we mentioned earlier. The d3p can be written as h bar to the third power times d3k. So the momentum kets must be equal to 1 over h bar to the power of 3 over 2, in order for these equations to be consistent. Furthermore, since the identity operator does not have any units, but the d3x, d3k, and d3p do, we can read off the units of the basis states. Now we are able to perform the main step of this video. If we start with a state vector psi, we can insert the identity operator and then write it in three different ways. We now identify the projection of the ket psi onto the basis states as the wave functions in position space or momentum space. Before we end this video, let us also discuss how the position basis and the momentum basis states are connected. In other words, we would like to know the meaning of projecting one basis state onto another. To find out, consider this term, where we have the momentum operator in between a position basis state and a momentum basis state. On the one hand, we can simply let the momentum operator act towards the right, giving us the corresponding eigenvalue. On the other hand, we can insert the identity operator next to the momentum operator and write it in terms of another position space basis. We know that the momentum operator corresponds to a derivative in position space, and since x and x prime have to be the same, we can integrate this expression using a delta function. Since these terms must be equal, we get a differential equation which can be solved by an exponential function. Finally, in order to determine this integration constant c, we look at this term, the inner product of x and x prime. On the one hand, since the position basis is an orthogonal basis, it must yield a delta function. But we can also insert an identity operator in the shape of the momentum basis. The integral over these exponentials gives 2 pi to the third power times a delta function. We can now write the h bar outside the delta function, which gives us h bar to the power of 3, since there are actually three delta functions here. We can only determine the absolute value of c, but it is convention to choose this constant real and positive. So c is 1 over 2 pi h bar to the power of 3 over 2. In summary, this is what the projections look like, and after a similar calculation, you get these relations between the position basis and the wave vector basis. Last but not least, these expressions are consistent with Fourier transformations between position space and momentum space wave functions. But that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching.